type 1 RPGN already discussed in previous lecture. Now type 2 and onwards the other type 3 RPGN I am discussing now. And so let's discuss about the type 2 RPGN. In the case of type 2 RPGN, there is majorly seen immunocomplex deposition, and this is majorly seen in case of the patient having the disease SLE or IgA nephropathy or HSP, Henoch Schönlein purpura. So what is the immunofluorescence diagnosis? If you diagnose this type 2 RPGN through the immunofluorescence technique, you can find in IF technique, immunofluorescence technique, you can find the granular immunofluorescence present. So in previous condition for the type 1 RPGN, you can find linear IF present, but in this case granular IF present. Remind us this. What is the treatment? Treat the primary cause. So it is secondarily associated with the disease of the patient who has suffering SLE, IgA nephropathy or HSP disorder. So you should treat the disease which is primarily occur in the patient, that is SLE, IgA nephropathy and HSP. This is the primary disorder of the patient. So you can treat primarily this. After that, it is treated by yourself or automatically it is cured. So in case of type 3 RPGN, there is no GBM antibody present. So here no immunocomplex deposition occur at the basement membrane of the glomerulus. And second is, it is also called Pauci immuno RPGN. This is the other name of the type 3 RPGN. Here you can find ANCA cells present. Two types of ANCA present here. First one is C ANCA and second one is P ANCA. In the case of C ANCA, you can find in the patient with Wegener's granuloma. You can find this C ANCA in the case of the patient with Wegener's granuloma. And P ANCA you can find when the patient with microscopic polyarteritis. For the type 1 RPGN, the diagrammatic view . This is the glomerular basement membrane. In the case of type 1, you can find in the glomerular basement membrane, there is a deposition of the immunocomplex like that. See, here antibody is attached with glomerulus, glomerular basement membrane. So, immunofluorescence showing, linear immunofluorescence present. To control the RPGN of the patient by the following technique, that is plasmapheresis. I already discussed in the type 1 RPGN discussion. Now, type 2 RPGN picture. Here, the basement membrane now, the immunocomplex found like that. So, it is like a granular. So, granular immunofluorescence found in the glomerulus basement membrane. In the glomerular basement membrane. So, it is also seen in the immunofluorescence technique. So, type 2 RPGN is a immunocomplex disorder. Is the immunocomplex disease. I hope you should understand. Next, type 3 RPGN picture. In case of type 3, you can find also that there is no deposition of the immunocomplex, but I already discussed that there is a presence of C ANCA and P ANCA. So C ANCA present in case of the patient with Wegener's granuloma, and P ANCA present in case of patient with microscopic polyarthritis. Now, clinical feature. History of a disease such as Goodpasture syndrome or vasculitis. So, the patient having a history of a disease of Goodpasture syndrome or vasculitis history. Second is the patient having rapid deterioration of decrease of renal failure. So, that causes decreased urine output. So, oliguria. And second is hematuria. So, patient having history of good posture syndrome or vasculitis, and patient having rapid deterioration of the renal failure, and there is a decrease of the urine output, that is called oliguria, and second is hematuria, that is present of hemoglobin in the urine. Now, diagnosis of the RPGN. First, due to the hematuria, so altered color of the urine, second, RBC cast present, because hyaline cast is a physiological cast which is already present in the urine, that hyaline cast made up of TAM horsefall protein, I already discussed in my first lecture. But when the hematuria case is arising, in that case the RBC present in the urine is attached with the hyaline cast or physiological cast, that is called RBC cast. So RBC cast present in the RPGN and associated with the hematuria. Now, reduced urinary output. Reduced urine output. If blood investigation we perform, you can find abnormal antibody. And finding of previously told the history of etiological disorder. History of etiological disorder such as Hennox-Cohn Barbuda or IgA nephropathy or SLE and also associated with the renal failure. So this is the history of the findings of the history of etiological disorder. And kidney biopsy. In kidney biopsy you can find immunofluorescence. So, in the case of type 3, there is no linear or granular immunofluorescence. So, in case of type 3, there is no linear or granular immunofluorescence. So, this is RPGN discussion, rapid progressive glomerulonephritis. I hope you can understand the type 1, type 2 and type 3 and associated with that, with its pathogenesis, etiological factor, clinical picture and diagnosis, blood investigation and treatment procedure. So, I hope if you read from this lecture, it is helpful for you for the UG level examination as well as PG examination. So, thank you.